Check it out, fresh coconut. Fresh oysters. Estos oysters son de hoy.
Sí.
¿Sí? Oysters, clams, y el pajarito, un lorito. All right, so aquí preparan las ostras con salsa y cosas así.
Sí, señor.
Ok, ¿puedo probar una, por favor?
The introduction to this vlog will be given in just a moment, but I found this way too interesting here.
Uno nomás. Quiero uno. Que la hagas uno nomás.
Para que venga otro, dígame. Papá, dilo, dime.
¿De cuál es? ¿De este?
Otro.
¿De este?
Otro.
¿O de este? Ahora vamos a call the same.
Uno de cada uno.
Uno de cada uno.
Para poner la diferencia. Uno. Wow.
Uno de cada uno.
¿Y esto lo trabajan en la mañana aquí?
Sí, lo traen en las mañanas. Esto se come muy popular con la salsa esta que hacen aquí en casa. Esa es muy buena, esa salsa. Se lo recomiendo esta, que se vaya a comer una que
con
le eche
esa salsa.
Con esa salsa.
Ok. Yeah. All right, so he cracked the shell open.
Sangra, ¿no? ¿Tiene sangre?
No, es como el caldito ese.
Como el caldito, pero sabe muy bueno.
Oh, ¿sí?
El de limón.
Y se comen todos así, crudos.
Sí.
Oh, boy.
We're in for a treat, guys. By the way, let me just tell you what's going on here, guys. This area here is the changueras, or
the ladies over there selling all the shrimps.
It's called la changueras. Basically, Mazatlan, Sinaloa is the seafood capital here in Mexico, and probably the shrimp capital of the world. They produce more shrimps here than almost anywhere else. And well, basically we're gonna go check that out over there, the shrimp sales. And the unique thing is that you buy the shrimps right there, fresh, and then various restaurants, probably like these around here, will cook them up for you. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. But first things first, we're gonna check out these. So aquí le pongo el limoncito.
Póngale poquito limoncito. Para quitar la poquita sal.
Poquita sal.
Casi con un poquito.
Y ya.
Lemon on it.
Some lime juice there. Lime juice here. Lime juice here. Remove this.
You eat spicy?
Oh yeah, very spicy, papa. Please.
¿Ah? Va saliendo el mar ya. Un calamar, calamar.
Un calamar ahí.
Este es calamar ya. Va a salir del mar.
Let's see, he wants to show me the calamares.
Mira, va saliendo el mar ahorita, mira.
Wow, fresquitos.
Fresco.
¿Y qué hacen con eso?
Eso lo cocemos, lo picamos, lo vendemos con ceviche.
Wow. Check it out, people waiting here for food. And well, basically, I'm going to try this. Huh? Oh, nací en Venezuela y fui criado en Miami.
Miami.
And she's from France.
Alright. Yo le pongo
mucho. Okay, so ya le pusiste esto hasta salsa.
Ya le puse la salsa, sal, le puse un poco de todo.
El sabor del mar.
Ajá. Esa casi cuando comes mariscos tienes que poner esa salsa. O sea, es muy buena.
Muy buena.
Muy buena salsa.
Okay.
Alright, guys, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. I'm excited.
Try for me.
I tried the oyster before, so that one's not new. What's wrong, buddy?
Because his little bird.
Trying to communicate.
He's like, oh, I'm from the Amazon,
no,
but
he's
now
telling
I'm here.
You, bon appetit.
Bon appetit. Bon appetit, Gope. All right. No, this is the oyster.
So we're gonna begin with this shell here. Check it out. It has this red piece here.
Not too sure, but we're just gonna go in and do it. That's good. The sauce is good. It's hot.
Picante.
Yeah, it's picante. But you taste this right away in there. It gives it a taste. And basically, it feels like I'm chewing on. Yeah, I love that, guys. Not all heroes wear capes. Some of them are just cutting up some shells over here, and they're heroes. But it's chewy, you know? Muchísimas gracias, hermano. This is gonna help me chug this down. It's very chewy.
So you could try it as well.
What is this?
Ceviche de camarón.
Ceviche de camarón.
Sí.
Sinaloan style?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Pretty good? Bueno. All right.
If you want to put lemon on it as well, or you can put salsa. All right,
yeah, definitely, I'm gonna do that.
You have a little spoon here?
A spoon. Alright guys, we're gonna go ahead and try this right here. Bam! We're gonna sprinkle some lime juice there. Bam! We're gonna try it out, guys. Ceviche Sinaloan style here on this tostada. They want me to try this, so I won't let them down. Mm. This is good.
Mm.
This is great, man. It's not good, it's great.
They do different kinds of this one. They do this one, and as well they can put pineapple in it. Do it like a Hawaiian kind of style. Tastes pretty good as well.
Yeah, I can imagine some pineapple here would be perfect. Yeah. Like a little sweet touch there.
Or mango,
yeah.
Put mango in it, it tastes pretty good.
Man. This is good. I like the homemade sauce too.
Thank you.
Delicious stuff. Check it out, we're gonna go in for this. ¿Este cómo se llama, hermano?
Pata de mula.
Pata de mula.
Pata de mula.
Pata de mula, eh.
I think mula es como una yegua, ¿no?
Un macho.
Alright. So they call this the leg of the donkey. Check that out.
Ahí tiene pata de mula, semillas, aguachile, puro calla, caracol.
Don't eat the shell.
This one is a little less tasty. Mainly you taste the sauce that they added there, as well as the lime. Mm. They got a piece of the shell in there. Again, very chewy. I mean, we all know exactly what oysters look like. No need to mask that. It's like a gummy. It's all about the freshness here. Y eso sale en todas las mañanas.
Todas las mañanas, va saliendo del mar ahorita. Va saliendo del mar. Sí, ahorita va a salir apenas. Aquí tengo todo nuevo, nuevecito todo el día.
Nuevecito todo el día.
Todo el día, nuevo. Nuevo, todo el día, aquí tengo yo.
¿Y a qué hora abren este sitio acá?
Aquí nosotros abrimos a las 5 de la mañana, estamos todo el día. De las 7 de la mañana a las 8 hasta las 5 de la tarde, 6.
¿Cómo es que se llama este?
Ahí tiene ostión, esa almeja, tiene ostión y pata mula, los tres tienen ahí.
Ok, pata mula, this is the almeja. And here we have the ostión, the oyster.
Tiene las tres cosas ahí.
All right, let's do it. My favorite is the oyster. Me gusta el ostión.
¿Te gustó más lo peón?
Sí, más suavecito.
Sí, más, es que está más de la textura de esta, está más, más gruesa esta.
Sí, por eso, hay que masticar esto más.
Sí. Aquí lo voy a poner. Ahí está la opción. La almeja, la pata. Ahí está todo. Ahí está el ceviche de camarón.
Yeah, everything ready there.
Yeah.
No sé, este ceviche está, man.
La pura calidad, cajeta. Recién hecho.
Calidad sinaloense.
Uno Sinaloa. Mándeme.
Yeah, guys, the ceviche, this one's my favorite right now. All right, I'm gonna finish this. Let's go check out the shrimps over there. Gonna pick a couple out. And we're gonna have them cooked and see how that is.
¿Cuánto es que es el total por todo, hermano?
85.
85
pesos.
Ah, bueno, aquí está.
Sí.
¿Qué hace con los huertos?
Sí. Muchas gracias. Gracias y que le vaya bien. Aquí estamos diario. Gracias. A ver, cuando se lo ofrezca, aquí estamos fresco el día.
Fresco
y
el día.
Y todos los días de las 8 hasta las 5 de la tarde.
Aquí está.
Aquí tenemos ostiones, almejas, pata de mulas, aguachiles, pulpo, callo, caracol, camarones para pelar, pura calidad, puro sí, bueno y fresco.
Mar ahí, aquí lo
del mar al paladar se llama. Mar paladar.
Mar paladar, ok.
Pura calidad, pura calidad. Adiós, dile. Dile adiós, dile a ellos. A ellos, dile adiós, dile. Dile pues.
Adiós.
Adiós, dile. Ándale, pues. Dígale adiós, pues. De la mano. Salúdenlo. Dile. Salúdenlo. Sí, a ellos, a mí no. A
está
ellos.
Penoso.
A ellos. Salúdalo.
¿Cómo que te habla a ti?
No quiere, no quiere.
No quiere.
No me dice a mí, pero usted, hermano. Ah, vergüenza, ahí estamos, ándale.
All right, you guys. I like the way he yells everything, guys. All right. We're going to take you now to the buffet of this vlog. And
it's served right in front of me right here. Check it out. It's known as changueras over here. And you have the freshly caught shrimps straight out of the Pacific. And they're just selling it here freshy fresh. Have a look at that. You can even get some fish. Check that out. Fish fillets there. Scallops. More shrimps. Yeah. Looks like the locals come. Aquí vienen y compran al kilo y se lo llevan para después cocinar.
A Chihuahua, vámonos.
A Chihuahua.
Chihuahua.
Allá, el otro estado. Wow, y se llevan todo eso así fresquito. Está bien. All right.
A la playa y luego a comer.
Está bien, bueno, buen provecho.
Gracias,
que les vaya bien. Have a look, guys. Octopus. Red thing, whatever that is. Oh man. Tuna. The octopus looks like some of the freshest. Check it out, everybody just comes here and gets their stuff. Wow. Lobsters. Amiga, ¿cuánto están las langostas?
$2.50.
El kilo. ¿Y más o menos cuántas langostas es un kilo?
Bueno, depende. Aquí estamos como unas cuatro.
Depende del tamaño, ¿no?
Little fish here. They have some crabs.
Y todo eso se lo traen los pescadores frescos en la mañana. Y eso es para darles agua a los caracoles.
Para que no se mueran.
She's basically keeping them fresh there by adding water to the shells. They're able to absorb it, drink, and not die, and keeps things extra, extra fresh.
Wow. ¿Y a qué hora empiezan a trabajar aquí, señora?
A las 5 de la mañana ya.
A las 5 empiezan a llegar los pescadores con los.
Sí.
Los animales frescos. ¿Y cuántos años lleva usted aquí?
Ay, pues ya ni me acuerdo.
¿Ya ni se acuerda?
No.
Oye, tengo una pregunta. ¿Las changueras vienen siendo ustedes o el nombre de este sitio?
Nosotros.
Aquí.
Pues ya hay muchas vendiendo camarón por otro lado y tienen unas changueras también.
Sí. Pero las originales están aquí, en esta calle.
Eso.
Ok. All right, let's see what else we find here. We got a couple more tents to scope out. There we have some crab meat as well. Different varieties of shrimp, all kinds of shrimp over here. Sizes, colors.
¿Cómo está ese? 170.
$170 for a kilogram of fresh shrimp. That's like $8 USD almost.
Oh, check it out. We have the price here.
The octopus bag is basically
$6 USD. Oh, man. Estoy viendo por ahora, de ahora vengo y escojo. Muchas gracias. Oh look, she has the lobster back there.
$2.20
¿Cuánto va a querer de este lindo? 80 pesos, este
parejito. I'm done scoping things out. Basically, I'm gonna buy a little bit from each different stall, and then we're gonna go to this place across the street here where they cook everything. So let's do it, guys. Este, amiga, quiero, si compro una langosta acá, la llevo allá y me la cocinan. Okay, una langosta, por favor. ¿Perdón?
Está a 3.50 el kilo.
¿3.50 el kilo y esta?
2.50.
¿Y cuál es la diferencia?
El tamaño.
Ah, el tamaño. Bueno, yo solo necesito una, por favor.
¿Por la de cal?
¿Ah?
¿De esta?
Sí. That one has a lot of meat there. $160. $160? Okay, sí, me la llevo, por favor. $160, we're talking about $8 USD for the big lobster. All right. Here, hold up.
Another one. It's still alive, no?
No, no, it's not alive. If it was, if this was alive, it would be... No.
You feel like it's gonna move, like...
Las langostas ya están muertas, ¿no?
Okay, I'm safe.
Okay, amiga, este, ¿qué sería la diferencia entre todos estos camarones? Menos, no, no hablemos del tamaño, pero el sabor.
El sabor, pues, este es más fuerte y este es más, es de estero y este es de mar.
Okay, bueno, entonces, deme unos cuantos de estos, por favor.
¿Medio kilo o qué?
No, es que es mucho, es que lo voy a llevar, voy a comprar un poquito de cada sitio y voy a llevarlo allá para que me las cocine. Entonces, no sé, unos 5 camarones, por favor.
Me meo
por un cuarto. ¿Por un cuarto? Ah, bueno, entonces un cuarto, pues.
Muy poquito, un cuarto. ¿A los dos? ¿Está muy bien?
No, es para yo solo.
¿Y a ella? ¿Qué va a ver? ¿Y a ella no le gusta el marisco?
Es vegetariana. Entonces esto es un cuarto. ¿Y esto cuánto viene siendo?
Viene siendo 50 pesos.
50 pesos, guys. $2.50 for these shrimps right there. Ok. Muchísimas gracias. Wow, bastantes mariscos, hermano.
Así es.
Así es, va para la playa ahora.
¿A la playa?
Alright, hey. People come here and they stack up on the seafood.
Let's go over here, let's find something else.
Este, estos son aquí, callos.
Sí. Este es callo redondo, le sale 700 el kilo. Y este es de almeja, le sale 250 el kilo.
Ok, ¿cuál es la diferencia entre este y este?
Pues el de H es más bueno.
¿El de este es el de sí, H?
Este es de H, pero es redondito.
Ok.
Más o menos sería su cuarto.
Más o menos así sería un cuarto. Ok, este, me llevo este, por favor. ¿Cuánto viene siendo?
$65.
$65? Okay. Me los llevo, por favor. Guys, so check it out. Look at this amount of scallops over here. $65 is basically $3.25 USD for that. Check it out. Hermano, aquí todo el día están poniendo hielo nuevo para mantenerlos fresquitos. Así. So all day here, guys, they're putting these big blocks of ice there, keeping things fresh.
¿Qué le damos,
oiga? Ah, estoy buscando cangrejo.
Pero,
¿es usted la única que los tiene acá?
Así es.
Está bien. Un cangrejito ahí, por favor. ¿A cuánto están?
Aquí
está 10 el kilo.
¿A cuánto?
110 el kilo.
Ok, bueno, dame uno, por favor.
33 pesos.
¿Cuánto?
3-3.
Guys, that's $1.50 for that crab. By the way, guys, you might be wondering who's holding all the stuff. Well, here's the crab.
There's a face behind it.
But here's everything. So it's Sulfinator holding everything.
I'm doing my workout session.
She won't participate in the food vlog as she's a vegetarian. And she doesn't even like seafood.
I don't like it anyway.
We have our seafood now, guys, and this is the place over here, right across the street. They'll cook everything up for you. Half a kilo, they charge that much. The full kilo, that much.
I'm glad you're not asking me to cook that myself.
Nah, I couldn't do that. All right, we're greeted by beer. I like it. I like it. Oh, wow, what a place.
Oh, my God.
Looks like a good place. Hello.
Hello, friend.
Check it out, guys. They're playing the Euros right now, and everybody's in here eating and enjoying the fresh food. Look how they serve stuff. No sé, voy a ir allá para que me los preparen.
Por eso, ¿cómo lo que empanizado? Para empanizar.
¿Cómo crees que son mejores?
Porque empanizado aquí esta medida ahí. Para empanizar, así.
¿Esos son los, la misma especie?
Sí, nomás que está muy grande.
Ok. ¿Y qué especie es? ¿Son los tigres?
¿Cuánto? ¿Con esos?
Un cuarto, por favor. I had to come back here because the shrimps that I bought, they weren't taking them back there at the restaurant. They said they weren't fresh enough, that they were yellow and I needed fresh ones. So they sent me back here to return them with the other vendor. And now I'm purchasing new ones.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien, gracias. Una pregunta, entonces, aquí cocinan todo esto, ¿no?
Sí. ¿Esto se lo quieres al ajo, guisado o crudo?
Guisado, por favor.
¿Al ajo?
Sí, como usted piense que sea mejor aquí, representando a Mazatlán, Sinaloa.
¿Empanizado?
Sí, por favor.
Al ajo.
Como usted,
mantequilla.
Como usted piense que sea mejor. ¿Y la langostica?
Igual.
¿Igual? Ok. Muchas gracias. So this is the staff here, guys. Check it out. This is where they prepare all the food. Buenas. ¿Cómo están? ¿Todo bien?
Todo bien.
And la super cocina de mariscos. Check it out. They have just mountains of shrimps there. Montañas de camarones. Bueno, dicen que Mazatlán es la capital de los camarones, ¿no?
¿Qué es?
Mantequilla.
Mantequilla.
Caldo de camarón con mantequilla.
Okay. Shrimp water with butter.
Este es caldo de camarón.
Caldo de camarón.
Y el jugo que sale de aquí va acá.
Okay.
Y ahí se vuelve para que vuelva a quitar
seafood feast without one of these first. A Pacifico, the hometown beer. Salud. La legends come here to have fresh seafood and play some dominoes and chow down a couple cold ones. All right.
Muchísimas gracias.
What it does look to me is it looks delicious right now, and I'm gonna go in and try this out first, guys. The fresh lobster. I'm just gonna go in with the hand here. Oh, still pretty hot. How much was the lobster? It was like
you say $8 or something.
Yeah, $8 for this gigantic lobster. Have a look, there's a lot of meat over here. They cook it with the juice of the shrimp. Oh my god. Tostadas, wow. Alright, they hook it up with everything, guys. So basically it's the juice of the shrimp. They mix it with butter, a lot of butter, some garlic, some garlic, some lime, and that's it. I'm gonna try this meat out just like that. Oh man. That is good. Oh man. Good and fresh. Oh, it's hot though. But just licking your fingers, you get the taste out of there, man. Oh Lord. Oh man. I'm gonna wait a little bit. It's hot. Just take this piece out and I'm gonna peel all this meat out of here. Woo! Just like that. Clean it out a bit more and check out this giant piece right here. Let's dip it into the sauce. There's like a little bit of juice here when they were cooking it. Look at that, you see when I put it on the juice, how juicy it gets, how colorful. Bam! All that's going in. So good. Bam. Tostadas. Doraditas. And we're gonna go ahead and fill it up with the scallops. Callos y hacha. Fresh scallops out of the Pacific. Oh man. That is good. That is darn good. You know, the first time I had scallops in Mazatlan, they gave them to me raw. I didn't expect that. Now they're cooked. Soft, tender, juiciness in there. Delish. Here we have my shrimp, guys. They have shrunk in size due to the deep frying, but check it out. Breaded. Let's try one alone. We're gonna try one of the shrimps now. With the sauces that they come with. Let's try this one out. Put a lot of that on there. It's hot. It's hot. It's a chili based sauce. Bam, it's hot, you feel it right away. Amiga, ¿esta salsa de qué es?
Tomate cocido con chile cocido.
Tomate cocido con chile. Bastante chile, chile, ¿no? Está picosa. Está buena. Next up, guys, we're gonna try this sauce over here. The second of the sauces. I think this one's gonna be good.
Is it a sauce with shrimp or shrimp with sauce?
It's a good sauce. Definitely mayonnaise based.
my type of sauce there. I like it. Next up, guys, is gonna be the crab meat over here. So I went ahead and picked out the best piece. That's the easiest ones to eat. We have this piece of meat just hanging out. Everything was cooked the same way except for the shrimps. Butter, the shrimp juice, garlic, and lime. Pieces of the show everywhere. It's good. Crab meat has never been one of my favorite things in the world. Probably why I suck so bad at eating it. But it's nice and soft. I can say that much about it. And well, it has that crab meat taste that is just something unique. And a lot of garlic taste here, you know. They put a lot of garlic on this food, so you really get the taste of that. Here I am trying to peel the shell out of this animal and get to the juicy, tender meat. Even after it has died, the body of this crab continues functioning. I don't want to hurt you, but I need one of those tools to break the legs. Oh, there we go. I think I'm just gonna suck this out. Not the best technique, but it worked. What an adventure. This is Mazatlan, Sinaloa, guys. Sinaloa overall is like a major seafood hub, and this place right here is called Las Changueras, and it's all that right there. If you're in town, definitely drop by, guys. It's a heck of an experience. You get your fresh seafood right there. You come in this spot back here, they'll cook it up for you. Not bad. You're probably wondering how much it costs to cook all my stuff. It was a total of 150 pesos. We're talking about $7.50 USD plus a beer to cook all that. It's probably cheaper if you just come and give them like a kilogram of shrimp or something and they give you like the whole tray, but not bad at all for four different things cooked deliciously. Yeah, I don't have anything else to say, guys. A lot of food. I'm gonna walk it off. And yeah,
anything to say, Sulfinator?
Even without eating it, it was interesting to watch though. Just come to check it out and see all this seafood, like unusual, so liked it.
And that's coming from somebody that hates the smell of seafood.
Yeah, it doesn't smell too bad. Like when you arrive, it smells a little bit, but after you just get used to it.
Yeah. It goes away, it's not very strong.
Not too bad.
All right, the French has spoken, Volpe has spoken. This is in the historic city center here of Mazatlan.
Hasta luego, guys.